New tonight, the woman who escaped the torture chamber of a sadistic sexual predator is breaking her silence. Cynthia Jaramillo believes there are other victims of David Parker Ray and is speaking out to help the FBI find them. Action 7 News reporter Ana Velasquez is live with her powerful message.
That's right, Royal. Cynthia Jaramillo spoke with Action 7 News back in 2005, but she hasn't given an interview since because, as you are about to see, what she endured still haunts her.
He knew what he was doing, and I was never going to be able to see my family again.
Cynthia Jaramillo doesn't like to talk about it, but she knows sharing her horrific story of the torture she suffered at the hands of David Parker Ray might help police find more victims.
Because what I went through, and these families deserve to have these people to know what happened. And these people need to be returned to their families, whether they're gone or not.
In 1999, Jaramillo escaped Ray's torture chamber, a trailer he called the Toy Box, running naked on a dirt road except for the dog collar around her neck still hooked to a 5-foot metal chain. She was abducted and kept for 3 days as a sex slave.
Did a lot of sick stuff. At one time, she said that she would kill me like others had been if he got off on me. At one time, he said that Daisy was okay, so I would. So I'm led to believe there was other victims.
Cynthia bravely comes forward today, hoping to generate leads on who this girl is. Her picture found on a fake ID in Ray's home, and to help families get closure.
Just to help these families, because my family would have probably been going through the same thing if I didn't get away.
Now, Cynthia tells me that what brings her comfort is knowing that David Parker Ray is gone. He died of a heart attack 8 months into his sentence of 244 years in prison for her sexual torture and those of two other women. Reporting live tonight from Northeast Albuquerque, I'm Ana Velasquez, KOAT Action 7 News.
Anyone with information is asked to call the FBI in Albuquerque at 505-889-1300.